Okay, it's finally happening. The to-be-determined the name of whatever it is called podcast.
Do podcasts start off like that, though? Like,
yeah.
With their first episode, they don't have a name yet?
Oh, maybe. Ours is.
Or are we the first podcast to not have a name?
Yeah.
And just
we
start.
Well, you don't want to, like, you want to change the meta.
We have a couple metas to change.
That is true.
One being not having a mic in our face.
Well, you can turn
maybe
your chair.
Maybe not a hood up.
Yeah. So you have a few metas.
So they can, like, see.
You have a few metas you need. We had what the WTF Fridays, which obviously is not Friday.
That's
not going to be it. Yeah. I didn't think that idea was very good on your part. I think we should have gone with something else.
Yeah, my idea.
Hex said the humdrum. I think that's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
And it's original.
If you guys don't know, just Google. I made like a stupid montage with the name humdrum. And just Google what it means. Honestly, at this point, I forget.
Yeah.
Also, when we're talking, do we look at the camera?
I'm going to glance back. I don't know. Do we?
I don't think.
Holy shit. Yeah, maybe we don't. I'm so used to it as like
I think it's like more of they're a fly. We don't know they're there. That's pretty.
Is that what podcasts are?
Yeah.
Kinda. Yeah, you're right. Well, I mean, for the Optic podcast, it's like they
that's not
talked,
it's like a
they talk
that's
to
like
camera.
The Breakfast Club almost. The Optic
okay,
podcast.
Yeah. So do you watch any podcasts? Or
Joe
listen?
Rogan.
Yeah.
The only one would be Joe Rogan's. And his is, I don't know, his is a little bit of both. They kind of like, they kind of are like interacting with the viewers, but it's mostly just conversation.
Yeah.
Like, it's like they're just a fly on the wall.
That's something
they just happen to be hearing. Like, the viewers just want to be in the room with you. Kinda.
Yeah.
They don't want like, well, I can't really say
crazy.
What they want, but it's more of just... them just listening in.
Right. I guess as like a doing YouTube content for so long and you're always looking at a camera.
Yeah.
That's just
and
like,
it's like
just
your
second nature just to like include the camera into the
it's like
conversation.
A different type of entertainment. Because this is like when we do vlogs and videos, it's more of not necessarily trying to be entertaining, but it's like you're doing something for someone to enjoy.
Yeah. Okay. Instead of just talking.
And this is just like chilling, I guess.
Okay. That makes sense. I watched Joe Rogan's. You actually put me on to Joe Rogan's podcast.
Oh, shit.
No,
I can't,
you can't unplug
like
that. Holy shit.
Wait, did I?
I think you're good. you were about to just rip off the whole recording equipment.
Is there another USB on that?
Yeah.
Do you need see, we can just do normal life stuff, like charging
like
phones.
Charge your phone? Are you going to tweet during?
Nah, I won't do that. Okay. There's certain things we're not going to be able to do. Like, we're going to have shit to talk about.
Is it charging yet or no?
Nah. Like, didn't you say you had, this being our first podcast episode, it's going to be like, where do we start?
Yeah, like, where do you want this to go?
Well, I was talking to, well, I guess this is like a time where I'm talking to the people listening. It's like, where are we gonna go with this?
I don't know.
I was telling Hitch, you know what we should do, and someone, well, no, they're not gonna steal it because we're gonna do it, but at the same time it's like, do I even want to say it or leave it a surprise of what,
well, if
my
you say it,
idea of what I
want
what I was
do.
Saying we, what we should do,
well, if you
just because it'd be different.
If you say it, then if anybody steals it, you still said it first. So you can say it.
Yeah, but should I leave it a surprise?
You're talking about
next,
the thing you
like
literally...
Like they click on our next episode for the podcast?
I'm down.
They're just like, what the fuck are they doing?
Yeah, I'm down.
So not saying
so
it?
So don't say
yeah.
it, yeah.
Yeah, you guys will just have to wait.
Have you ever seen Bill...
But I'm not talking to you. You're just listening.
you guys, you fly on the wall.
You flies are going to have to
Big
wait.
Brother, whoever's listening.
Fly cast.
Have you ever listened to Bill Burr's podcast?
A little bit, yeah. Just because I know he was on Joe Rogan's podcast,
okay. And
then Joe Rogan will mention Bill's podcast, and so I'd like randomly listen in.
Yeah,
but yeah, his is pretty good too.
It's crazy.
It's like him by himself.
Yeah, he doesn't
and
have
just
anyone
ranting,
and he just
this is literally his his therapy. Yeah. That's his podcast.
Oh, for sure. He definitely, you can tell he does it for himself more than he does it for
just
the
blowing
podcast.
Off steam the whole time.
But it's like the way he, like how good he talks and like forms together sentences and ideas is like, it's kind of like mesmerizing. Like you can't help but listen.
Yeah. That's like what comedians do.
Yeah.
That's why they're so good. It doesn't like matter what they're talking about. It's just something is being said and you're listening.
Right.
They just have a way of saying stuff.
Being a comedian, I've always said that being a comedian would have to be like the hardest like profession to get into.
Why was I thinking about that the other day? I was like, I was like, comedians, like how hard it is to, all right, just say doing an intro for a smooth competition. Like, what's up, guys? Bringing you another episode of Brisbane. Like, we'll do that and we'll fuck up like five times.
But no one ever gets it.
Just
only
because you're like
full
on the spot. Yeah. And it's like, what do I say again? Stuff like that. And then to be a comedian, it's like you're literally put in front of like hundreds to thousands of people. And it's like, make me laugh.
Yeah. But like, what I've always thought is, how do you get to that point? Like, how do you just become Kevin Hart? And you're just performing.
I've literally heard Kevin Hart literally say that. They're like, how did you become Kevin Hart? And he's like, you don't just become Kevin Hart.
Right.
He's like he'll always say, like, he's been doing it for like 15 years or whatever. Yeah. It's like, it's kind of like the same thing. How do you become Hitch or Maniac?
Yeah, I guess it makes sense.
Like, it's just, how do you join Optic?
It's just, it seems like.
It starts out as like loving whatever you're doing.
Yeah, like just putting your all into into it,
but like, it seems you don't even notice it.
It seems like being an actor, an actress, like you go to, like, obviously you don't really hear of the people that are like on the come up until they like make it big or they're in a movie that you just randomly watch. But like, there is still, you go to school, then you go to either LA or New York, and then you just pray. You just hope you get a manager or an agent or a amazing role, and then you'll make it.
I wonder how many truly talented people there are that haven't
that
made
just
it.
Just don't ever make it.
Yeah. Because I feel like if you really do have it, it'll happen somehow.
The law of attraction.
Yeah.
All right, you got me into like the Joe Rogan podcast, and so then now on the side of the
like
YouTube,
recommended.
It's all just like motivational montages, like 30 minutes long.
Which one did you watch? The Law of Attraction with like all the celebrities, like Denzel, Will Smith.
I think Will Smith is.
Well, I think he has like a clip in it.
Yeah,
but I'm talking about when all the actors. Excuse me, I don't know if you could hear that. It was a bunch of actors. It was like Denzel, like sitting in a circle. Did you see that one? It was like Denzel, Leonardo DiCaprio.
They're talking to each other?
Yeah. Like all those great actors, like in a circle.
Like A-list.
And one of the subjects they talked about was like law of attraction. And just like thinking about stuff will bring it like to a
reality.
Bring it to life. Or which, like believing.
I mean, that's something that it's really easy to say that once you've made it, I guess.
Yeah.
But like, are there people that literally
life? I'm sure there's plenty of delusional people that think they have it and it never comes.
Yeah, that's true. I guess
you
being
just
real
don't
with
hear
yourself.
About them.
Being real with yourself is very important too. Like I went to the mall one time in Greensboro, and there was like this little kiosk, and there was this lady there that had a recording studio, and I went in there and I was like, I was like rapping at the time with like my roommates, and I was like, hey, like my roommates were like, yo, Hitch, Davis, you should go see how much it would cost to like get recording studio or get recording time. And so I walked in, and there was this lady, and it was very obvious that she was trying to push her own content rather than like push like recording time.
Really?
Yeah. So I was like, how much would it be for like an hour in the recording session or like to record or whatever? And she was like, oh, that would be like $75. But if you want to hear this and the quality, I'm the best. I'm the best rapper on the East Coast.
What?
And I was like,
I mean,
and so I bought it. I bought the CD. I bought the CD, and then I couldn't get through like three tracks. I couldn't get through three tracks.
They're garbage.
Yeah, and
people. I've never been impressed with someone that's like, "Yo, you should check out my music." And it's like,
dude, same.
Yeah, I put out some music, but I don't do it because I think it's good and I'm trying to make it.
Right.
I just do it for like, because I enjoy it, and it's like kind of entertaining or whatever.
Because I feel like,
because like I'm a pro gamer, but like doing this. But I'm not out there like
I'm the best rapper.
Check me. Buy this.
Buy this. I'm the best rapper in esports.
Like, I would never sell beats unless I know they're that good.
But I feel like that comes back to like the law of attraction thing. It's like, yeah, you have to be obsessed with something, and yeah, you have to put your all into it, but you also have to be real with yourself. Yeah.
So, well, some people literally don't have that fucking whatever it is. They just don't have that thing that makes you aware.
Yeah. That makes
sense. Of sucking.
If you like go through life, like if I went through life obsessing over basketball and said, I want to be a professional basketball player, I'll stop at nothing. It's never going to happen. Like, I just don't have the ability.
Yeah. You just don't have it.
Yeah. You just don't have it. So you have to be real with yourself. If you don't have it and what you do have, there's always something that you can do. It's like,
it's not like seeing something and like, I can do anything. No, you can't. But what you can do is figure out what you could be great at.
Yeah, exactly.
Not like, there's just some stuff you're not going to be good at.
Yeah. I mean, I was just like,
there's some stuff you can put so many more hours into than other people, but they'll just be better.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. It's like, you can always find something too. Like for me, I like loved video games or whatever. It's just always something that my generation grew up with. And then I wasn't good enough to actually play.
Yeah, I guess you can.
So I literally found a way to get in without doing it that way.
You went like, yeah. You're like the rapper that couldn't rap.
I'm DJ Khaled of esports. But yeah. So this is how the podcast. Do we talk to them?
Yeah.
This is how the podcast is going
to
go. This
being the first episode, we need to, I guess.
That's actually hilarious because I wrote down things just in case. I feel like we won't ever have a problem getting stuck of what to talk about.
There's definitely some stuff that. Like, even Joe Rogan, not to always reference that, but, like, even his podcast, it's, like, there's some stuff that, like, you know, people are going to kind of want to hear, or at least, like, say, tragedy or something happens.
Oh, yeah.
Like, we could get into something else for, like, an hour, but it's, like, oh, shoot, we should have kind of talked about this.
Yeah.
So there's definitely some stuff we should try to have some kind of subjects in case we run dry here.
That is actually crazy because on my little notebook, I wrote, what the WTF Friday podcast. And then I wrote content creator career, different roads to how we got here, which we just talked about. Yeah. And then I also wrote down a law of attraction.
Really? That was like the first fucking thing we talked about. All right. Well, now we're out of ideas.
Now all the ideas.
Dude, I'm getting this chair.
What do you mean? What? Are you that uncomfortable?
Yes.
Okay. We'll move the coffee off of it. All right. Anyway. But what else did I write down? Okay. We can talk about this. So
while I was meta already, getting the new chairs. Oh, wait. We'll have.
Wait till the new chairs come in. Special podcast edition chairs. While I was at, dude, I think I have the worst luck at airports. We don't have to get into it, but I haven't had an on-time flight. I literally don't think ever in the past 6 months. I don't think I've had a flight leave on time.
What's crazy is I've been flying since 2007 and I've only had one delayed flight, and it was at like after Christmas to come back here.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
What?
I don't know how, but I've missed But then, well, actually.
Well, don't you miss flights all the time?
Yeah, but it's like, if it was delayed, I'd make it. So it's kind of fucking me. If my flights That's were true. Delayed more often, I'd make more flights. Because I miss flights all the time. I'm just such a procrastinator. But yeah, it is crazy. People talk about missing flights all the time.
I don't think
I'm just like, I've never. I was literally always saying I've never had a delayed flight until after Christmas to come back here, like the 27th or 28th of December.
I've only missed one flight, and that was the first time I ever flew, because me and Blake had a connecting flight in Atlanta, and when we got off the plane in Atlanta, we went back out to go get our bags from baggage claim.
But you left and had to recheck. Like, go through security.
Well, we went to go get our bags from baggage claim because we didn't realize that we picked up our bags. Like, our bags were connecting, too.
Yeah.
This was the first time I'd ever flown, so I didn't know anything. So it was like, so we have to go get our bags and then recheck them in, right? And so we stood at baggage claim forever. And then they were like, I went up and I was like, hey, were we supposed to get our bags? And they said, yeah, you pick up your bags in New York. So that's the only time I've ever missed a flight.
Have you ever just completely forgot your bag?
What?
Like, just like I had a carry on, and it was like one of those suitcases that you just roll with you,
right?
And I literally just left it there.
You just walked off the plane and forgot about it.
Yeah.
Did you ever get it back?
Never saw it again.
What? Yeah. Was there anything expensive in there?
I don't think so. Just clothes, but it was like nice clothes and like a full suitcase too.
Dang. No, I've never done that.
So I was pissed.
You just forget.
I don't know. I've done it. Actually, I've only done it like one or two other times, but it's like made it to baggage. Or no, I've checked in my bag. It goes to baggage claim, but I never pick it up. Like one time, I landed here and like got an Uber for back to the house, and I'm like standing out there for my Uber, and then I'm like, wait a sec, I don't have my bag. So I like go down to the baggage claim and I look for it and I don't see it. And I'm like, what the fuck? And then they're just like, what color is it? Blah, blah, blah. Is your name tag on it or something? And I'm like, no, like there's nothing in it that I was like, I can tell you what's inside of it. I think they just trusted me off that and I just got it back.
Oh.
But they had to like go get it. Took like 20 minutes just to get my bag back. Missed the Uber.
Well, anyway, where I was going with that was
what was your story?
So I got off the cruise ship and Hex was like, okay, I'll get you your flight from Miami to Atlanta, what time? And I was like, well, I don't know what time I'm going to be off the ship, so like later in the afternoon would probably be best. So I told him that, and then I put my phone on airplane mode for the entire cruise, didn't talk to anybody. And then when I got back off the cruise, Hex was in Mexico with his phone on airplane mode. So I had no idea what time I was going to be departing.
Do you even know what airline?
No, I had no idea what airline. So I just went in and he was like, what airline? And I said, like the Uber. He was like, what airline? And I was like, American. Like, I just made one up. And then I went in to the American terminal, put my credit card in, like where it like matches up your name, and it printed off. All right.
That's so lucky.
They were like, Robert Edwards. I was like, yeah. And so I hit it, and then it said departing time. I got there. I got to the airport at 9:30 a.m. because we got off the boat super quick. And then the ticket printed off, and it said 9:45 p.m. Was like, I'm cool at sitting in an airport. I don't have a problem with it, but
12 hours.
So I went up to the person. I was like, is there any way I could like change my flight? And they were like, every flight from Atlanta or from Miami to Atlanta for the rest of the day is booked. Like, we don't have anything else.
I feel like they just say that. I don't know if I believe them ever.
Yeah.
Every flight I'm on, I see at least one open seat.
That's true. But that could be somebody missing the flight. That could be literally anything. But as far as like tickets sold, I mean, you can't sell a ticket if it's already.
I don't know.
But anyway, so I was sitting there and I was like, what am I going to do? I edited for a little while. I watched like a...
Nice. I wonder if somebody can pick that up.
Dude, You've been doing that a lot lately. Anyway.
I'm not going to hold it in. Oh.
I can't smell. So I was sitting there. Are you all right?
That's bad.
I was sitting there. I edited. I watched some movies. And then there was like a bookstore right there. And I was like, I'm
is
not
that
a,
when you bought the book and tweeted it?
Yeah. I'm like, I'm not a big reader. But if there's a bookstore right here, I might as well read something. And I was like, but I have nothing. I don't want to read like a fictional drama or anything like that. So I was just like, I'm going to buy like a.
That's why I don't watch TV shows.
Life. Oh, I tear through TV shows.
I don't know. I just don't get it.
You don't get like.
I don't like fall into the fantasy world. Of like anything,
I guess for me, it's
I'm too much of a realist. Like I don't, if it's not like people will like Game of Thrones and like I can't relate to Game of Thrones, like because that's not super unrealistic, but it's like back in the day type shit.
But that's like the thing with Game of Thrones for me. It's like it's kind of like somebody like one guy. Just had this like open canvas of imagination and he built like a world. And it's crazy how many different like storylines link up with each other.
Yeah. I mean, I understand the talent and creativity behind it, but I don't know. I wish I could because I'm fucking bored half the time. But I don't know. I can't get into TV shows. It's only like certain types of movies that I'm into.
Right.
I don't watch like the only types of movies I'd say I do watch would be like comedy, but mostly it'd be like thrillers and like kind of like mind fuck movies.
Oh yeah.
Where you're just like, what?
What's the movie you want me to watch? Old Boy.
Yeah. Old Boy.
Still haven't watched it.
There's probably a lot of the movies that I haven't seen many movies at all, but probably the ones that I have seen, you need to see, or you probably haven't seen,
right?
Because it's like all the weird movies.
Yeah. Yeah, but anyway, about the book, I was just like, I was just like walking around. And I was like, what am I doing in here? Am I gonna get like a magazine? I was like looking at the Maxims. I was like, no. So then
is this the part I tell a story about me buying one and then we can get back to yours in 10 minutes?
I thought you were going to tell your Playboy Maxim stories. No.
I do have one though.
Do you really?
Yeah, we won't. Well,
All right. So I was just walking around. I was like, what am I going to read? And then I saw like a self-motivation section or self-inspiring something.
Oh, that's my
like.
Section.
Yeah. And
it's like, I don't read books, but that's a section I go to if I do read books.
Yeah. I remember when Ace was here, Ace was like, because we would always just sit there and then somebody would be like, man, can we fucking start reading? Or like they would say something like that. And Ace said that. He was like, can we start reading? And I was like, I bet you Nick reads, but the only thing that Nick reads are like, Power of the Mind.
Yeah, books. That's all. That's the only thing I've ever read.
Yeah,
I've read one. I've read Holes, but not. I like fake read it.
That's a good ass book. Though.
Yeah, it is good.
But yeah, so I was like, I might as well. I've never decided to read anything willingly in a very long time.
Is it weird? I'm looking. They can't tell.
I was looking through this part of the
the little bar.
You can see me through it.
You're looking straight through it with both eyes.
I wasn't even gonna. I didn't even think about it until you said it.
Every time you look over now, I'm just like this.
I just see like just two bars in your little eye, just like squeaking through.
I'm gonna not face the camera. Let's be that podcast. What if we turn the projector on and it's like. We should like it's we like were like class. Daft Punk. They never saw us.
It's like a class lecture.
And we turned that on to where they could only see the back of our head. Like the
we're just a silhouette.
We're like puppets. How you do like
yeah silhouette?
Is that what it?
Yeah.
What it'd be called?
But imagine. What if all the lights were off and then just that was white and then
with our
just head and then we could just like face each other, and dude, then it would still that would be kind of dope, right? We can call it the.
We can just do like random shit for like random episodes. Like,
oh, that. I'm down. Yeah. That could be one episode. The thing you were saying before.
Yeah, that could Let's write these down. Write it down.
I don't have. Do you have a pen? Put it in. Yourself. Yeah. All right. So anyway, I was walking through the
through the bookstore.
I was like, and I remembered that one story with like, or we were like the three of us were going to Mago. And you said that, I was like, I might as well read something like that. I've never read anything like that before. So I got a book about character and I got a book about motivation, but I think I left the book about motivation in Atlanta. So
nice.
But the character book is pretty good. That's the one I started reading anyway. What books? Oh,
building, like building your character or whatever.
Yeah. It's a number one bestseller on New York Times.
I feel like I've seen too many books with that title. Yeah, that it's lost
I feel
its
like
credit.
The number one New York Times books changes like every 15 minutes, just so people can put that on as like a marketing scheme. And I knew I was getting tricked when I bought it, but I still bought it.
Yeah.
Just to build character.
That happens every time you buy anything, really.
That's true. What books have you read as far as...
I have a terrible memory, so I honestly couldn't tell you the names.
The titles of them?
Yeah. I'd have to like Google shit I've bought.
I
don't know why I'm so bad with titles. Like on say every Drake's album, I could say the lyrics in the song. Dude, but if you say what's the name of the song, I honestly couldn't tell you.
Well, for like Drake,
it's weird.
Especially with Drake's albums, because I just put it in and listen to the entire thing through.
Yeah.
Like Bryson Tiller's album, I don't know if I could tell you any of the songs, but I could sing every single word to them. But yeah, I'm the same way with the character. I call it the character book because I don't know the title. But I mean, it's a good ass book.
Yeah.
Just and he speaks as in like I've never read a book where he's like in the following pages I'm gonna say this or this or we're gonna dive deeper into this, and it's like kind of somebody's talking to you rather than. You're really? Reading like a book just about anything. He's like directly speaking to
it's
the
like a psychiatrist.
Writer. Yeah. Or to the reader. He's like constantly breaking that wall between audience and teller.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
The fourth wall.
It's like a different way of writing a book.
Writing. Yeah. Because you're like super into like motivating things. Did the book that you read change anything? Did it change your perspective?
For a while, but then it's like I always do something like that.
Yeah.
And then just fall back into like the
habit.
Yeah.
The habit of things.
Yeah. The habit of things is a good way of putting it.
Yeah.
I just fall back into the like I was working out. I would like make myself read for like at least 15 minutes a night. And I was on what I did notice was reading would make me really tired. So I would read and by the end of like 15 minutes, I'd literally just want to go to sleep.
Dude.
But like, cause recently I've been working out and shit, but it's like, I'll still be up till 6 a.m. just literally sitting there just being like, God, I wish I was tired.
Yeah.
But it's like, I'll be tired to where like the bed's comfortable, but it's not tired enough to actually fall asleep.
That's the worst type of tired.
But like reading definitely always made me just for some reason, just made me tired to like fall asleep.
Yeah. You just like,
but I mean, I did feel, I felt good about my days for sure. I don't know if that's just like a,
yeah,
because I think I'm doing stuff. So I feel good.
I think there's like a positive.
I think there's always something about like you think you do because you're doing stuff. You think you like look at yourself as a better person just because you're doing stuff.
I'm reading. Because, yeah.
Working out.
Just because you're not laying
I
there.
I feel good.
Being a slob.
But then I realize I fall back into like the habit, the fucking, I fall back into the pits of hell, as I'll call it. because I'm doing that stuff and it's like, yeah, maybe it's not all that great. And then that's when I start like declining off. Yeah.
No, I mean,
like if it was really that good when I keep doing it.
Dude, I feel like a good way of like a good metaphor for that is like when you said like you clean your room's like super spotless. And then like one thing will like fall on the floor. It's so easy to clean that one thing up. Yeah. And so your room stays spotless for a long time. Yeah. And then.
But if like something happens to where a couple of things got messed up.
And you're just like, oh, I can pick those up in the morning.
Yeah.
And then you fall asleep. And then before you know it, your room's just a fucking pigsty.
Yeah.
And then you're overwhelmed.
It's crazy.
And then
you're just like, I don't feel like doing
it. Yeah, it's not easy to clean it up anymore. So you're just engulfed in this disgusting room.
Yeah, it's kind of like you're kind of like that. It's kind of like health as well.
Yeah.
You could easily start now and prevent from getting a disease at 40, 50, or you could get the disease at 40 or 50 and then be like,
I should have.
Well, fuck, it's like too late and there's so much work to dude,
such a dark thought, but yeah. It's so real.
Yeah.
But like, yeah. That I don't know. Do you think people that do get like not like super serious diseases, but definitely like things where if they had just been healthier growing up, then it could have prevented it? Do you think they really regret how they grew up, or do you think they just?
I'm sure they don't regret it. Well, I'm sure they regret it, but I'm sure they live with it. Because you don't want to just live the rest of your life like regretting it. So I'm sure they like talked to themselves in some way to like ease the pain of living with it.
You have to be realistic.
But I mean, most diseases are at least, I don't know. I'm not a scientist or whatever. Or I'm not a doctor.
Or a scientist.
But I think a lot of diseases, I'm sure, come from not taking care of yourself while growing into an adult and living in life years and years of eating foods you shouldn't, stuff like that, not exercising. All that stuff causes diseases. That's why there's more diseases now than ever, because how fake our food are. Or how fake our food is.
And our work is fake because our work is sitting down at a computer screen and just filing information into it.
No exercise. Your body doesn't move. You do podcasts. And just sit there. Instead of going to the gym, you decide to do an hour-long podcast.
and then you talk about how pure
concentrate coffee to where you realize you haven't stopped talking since the podcast started. You're only three sips deep. Literally.
I was like, you're really talkative today, man.
This looks like a used cup.
It's not a used cup, I promise.
Where'd you get it? Down here?
Yeah. No. Not down here. In the cabinet. I peeled it off of where all the unused cups were. Because these two.
This shit works.
Yeah, right?
I'm going to start buying this.
It's good.
This is like that good, good.
The good, good concentrated
coffee. I'm not much of a coffee or caffeine person, but I don't know. I think this stuff's working. Because before I came down here, I was in my bed. Yeah. I could have fell asleep.
Dude, I think if I would have gone
up. I mean, it is
up,
midnight, to be fair.
Is it
but
really?
I also woke up at 3 p.m. Yeah, to be more fair.
And the day before that, I think you were only awake 6 or 7 hours to begin with, and then you slept for like 45.
Well, the niacin. We could talk about that.
Let's tell the niacin story, because I didn't really even see it.
Well, I have to really. All right. Well, I guess by the time this comes out, it'll be up because it's in Seth's vlog from yesterday. So I think his vlog will be up probably tomorrow.
He got like the peak of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
He got it when it was like at its worst.
I have to watch that.
But yeah, you'll see if you watch that, you'll see me and Seth standing beside each other purposely with our shirts off because of how red I was from this pill that I took. It's a legal pill called niacin, which I've looked it up before. It's like, it's supposed to be good for you in like a bunch of different ways. But one of the ways was I plan on taking it and then going to the gym, which is like a beneficial way of taking it because it like opens up your pores and like, I guess, I don't know if it like makes it easier to sweat or either way, it opens up your pores. A lot of people take it to do that and then they work out and then they'll like get in a sauna and it's like a detoxing kind of thing. It like cleans the toxins out of you. It's just like a healthy thing to do. So I do that. At least I think that's what I'm about to do is take this niacin, then go to the gym, have a nice workout, blah, blah, blah. You know, detoxify myself. And then I end up taking it. GNC. I see niacin. So I'm just like, oh, I'll get this. Pick it up, grab it, buy a bottle. It's like 500 milligrams each pill. I don't really know. For certain medications, that's a lot. For others, it's probably not a lot at all. So I don't know. I just see niacin. I buy the bottle. So I get home. I like look it up a little bit, and they're telling it says something about a flush. I was like, "What is a flush?" They were like, "If you take this, you might get a slight flush, or you might get a flush, but don't be worried because it's only a flush. Nothing bad has ever happened from a flush." And I'm like, "Okay, whatever."
Whatever a flush is.
So I take it. I take just one. I was literally about to take three pills because it's like if you have a headache, you take like two or three Tylenol.
Yeah.
You don't just take one Tylenol.
I'm glad you didn't do that.
Yeah. So I was like, I'm about to take three of these. But I read some dude who was like, I took one, waited a little bit, took another, waited a little bit, took another. I was like, okay, I'm just going to take one. So I just took one. And then I'm just sitting there chilling. I kind of forget that I even like took it. And it's like 15, 20 minutes pass. And then I'm just like, whoa, what the fuck? Like something, it felt like something just like expanded, like a heat wave expanded in my forehead. I was like, whoa, that's the flush. I'm like, and then you can literally feel it like going from your forehead down your cheek to like down your neck to into your chest. And then suddenly it's just like throughout your whole body and your whole body is just burning. The most realistic way I can put it is it feels like you're just sunburnt everywhere. And I just started getting super hot. I was like, what the fuck? I go and look in the mirror and I'm just beet red. And it's like 10 degrees outside. My room is cold anyway. I have my sweatshirt on and shit. But I'm just burning up. I like open my door. Open my window, and it was just so hot. I like rip off my sweatshirt, and I'm just super red. And I just feel like I look at my hands, and literally, you can probably still tell right now.
Hey, can you? Does it look
like your pores are just like super open,
yeah.
Like bigger?
Then, like, yeah.
Like my pores. I looked at my hand, and it just looked like every. Like, just imagine every little hole that a hair grows like out of is expanded. And it just looked like my skin was, like, opening with holes everywhere. Because that's how, like, open my pores were. Because it, like, rushes blood to your pores or whatever. And then I go to Mike's room and I was like, do I look red? He was like, yeah, what the fuck? And I was just like, dude, and I, like, explained the whole thing. And then I'm sitting there and I'm just like looking at my pores and I'm like, does it look like my pores are just super open? He's like, what the fuck is this? And it was just crazy.
So,
and then I was just beet red for like an hour and I kept getting these weird sensations. Sometimes I would feel bad. Sometimes I went through like 10 minutes of feeling like my entire body was getting massaged on the inside. I was like, this is the shit. I was like, I'm going to take this every day because I was like feeling so good. But then it like that wore off quick. And then I found myself in the shower for like 20 minutes.
Like feeling just, like, sick?
Not like sick, but like really achy. Almost like you're about to get the flu. But.
Okay.
You don't have really any symptoms besides like achy and tired.
Drowsy.
Yeah. And I was just sitting in the shower with the with it like almost as hot as it can go and just like sitting there in the steam hoping it. Oh, because at that time I started getting freezing. I was freezing by that time.
What?
It went from hot to like super cold. That's why I got in the shower.
From hot to red to pory.
To still just red, cold as shit and red.
Red, cold as shit.
So I was just sitting in this shower trying to just like sweat it out in the steam.
Dude,
and just like drinking water. And I was just like, how is this pill legal? Like if I took, I don't know what would have happened if I took three of those.
So basically, you looked it up later. You were supposed to take like half a pill or a fourth of a pill.
Yeah. I looked it up. All right. So I took 500 milligrams and I looked it up later and everyone was like, for your first time taking it, you should take 50 to 100 milligrams.
So one fifth of a pill.
Yeah. So one fifth of what I took, possibly one tenth of what I took is what you're actually supposed to start out with. So that's I went through.
Insane.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you told me you took, you were like, yeah, apparently you're supposed to take 100, and I took 500. And I was like, why would you do that? But I didn't realize 500 was one pill. And so it's just natural just to take one pill.
That's crazy. Because like, it's like how much could, if you take every, say you go into a GNC, you buy every single pill bottle possible, and you laid each out, each just one pill. I bet nothing affects you more than the niacin.
Yeah. That's
like,
crazy.
That's just
scary.
I didn't know a legal pill could do that. Like, you could probably take a morning after pill as a guy, and it'd probably affect you less. Or, like,
what
just weird shit. I don't know.
What the fuck?
Like,
I've never
Say you took
about
a pregnancy
that.
Pill as a guy. Like, that would probably affect you less than this shit. Like, I don't know what could affect you more for just taking one of those
pills.
Just
one tiny pill.
Or why there's such a large dose.
Yeah, right? Why did you see any other bottles while you were there? Of like smaller
I'm sure
doses?
There was. I just wasn't paying attention. I just saw him. I was like, oh, I'll try this out.
That's crazy. I honestly think another fun fact is that was the first time I'd ever been in a GNC was yesterday.
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez.
So I was just like, I worked at Walgreens, so I knew what a lot of the stuff was because there's like vitamins and stuff everywhere in Walgreens, but there was a lot of stuff that I had never seen before. There was like hangover pill. Yeah. Did you see that? Like you're supposed to take it. And
there's, I think we have some of that stuff here.
Here?
It's not I think it's like a powder you put into water.
Huh. But so then you were talking about everything because you went and bought like stuff that you probably don't even need.
Just
but
vitamins. I'm gonna.
But then you were like talking to the lady, and then she said, "Yeah, we actually have this one like natural." She was a nursing student. She had this like natural.
She seemed smart.
Focus. Yeah, she knew what she was doing. She had been working at GNC for like 5 years. What she said.
Oh really?
Yeah, and then she like she quit for a little while to focus more on nursing school, and then now she only works weekends. So that's what she knew what she was talking about. She was like, yeah, there's like this one natural herbal pill that me and my college roommates take like whenever we're studying for big finals. And I was like, I would like one of those. So I got one of those.
Fake Adderall.
Yeah. But so anyway, I took that yesterday and I mean, I felt fine.
Did you feel anything?
Yeah, I mean, I
want to take one.
Yeah, I mean, I'll give you one. But I felt like, I took one right before the podcast, and I feel like I've been pretty talkative, so.
Yeah.
And I'm really bad about focusing. Did you?
Because she told us about one stuff, and she was like, it's pretty much, it's caffeine.
Yeah, she said this is different than just like a caffeine pill. Yeah. And I've taken a caffeine pill before, and it's literally just like chugging a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
It's not like, really? It's not like anything else.
Yeah.
But this, it feels like I can like focus on what I want to say next. That was ironic because I couldn't think of what I wanted to say next.
I feel like I can really just focus on what I want to say next.
But yeah, I mean, it's, I don't know. It's always been kind of weird, like messing in that area, the caffeine pill,
dude, I don't know if that's what I was saying about this. I don't know if I found my next addiction. But, like, look how much I've drank.
Your concentrated coffee addiction?
Yeah.
And I just hope, I mean, the only thing with that, it could get you really jittery. Luckily, we just ate steaks and stuff, so you probably are good.
Well, I also, because I do get really jittery with coffee, but that's why I've only drank that much.
That makes sense. I haven't drank a lot of mine either, but we've also been talking.
Wait, did you have this exact one?
No, I have a different one. I have like a canned one. I just keep buying different coffees.
I'm not like much of a caffeine person, but I don't know. Caffeine, well, I'll have to keep trying. Caffeine doesn't affects really me differently different days.
Yeah, caffeine doesn't really like affect me. Like growing up drinking, like you had your friends that were not allowed to have Mountain Dew because they would go wild and their parents would freak out. I was never that weird. Kid.
I've like drank water my whole life.
What?
I was never like a big soda guy. Never like a big. I just always, because as a kid, I was forced to drink water.
Okay.
Even for like dinner, we weren't allowed soda. Water. Always water.
Yeah.
Maybe like a cup of soda with lunch or something. But even that was rare. And then I don't know. After that, I kind of just, it was either I would always stay that way or just turn complete opposite.
Just drink nothing.
Like I did in other ways.
Trash.
Because I went from not, I was never allowed inside until it got dark out. And then even when it got dark, I couldn't play video. Like I had to like study or do homework or like watch TV or something. I couldn't play video games for some reason.
Yeah, I was raised the same way.
So it's like whenever my mom and stepdad got divorced, it was nonstop video games just because how much I loved it.
Right. Yeah.
But with the water, it just always stayed that way. I just always, it's either water or alcohol, really.
Those are the
but
two
even
things
alcohol
you've
tried. Is rare, yeah.
When you were a little kid, it was either water or alcohol.
As a kid, I don't think I drank anything else. I mean, maybe Gatorade or something.
I always said that soccer ruined my taste for water because I played soccer for so
it's
long.
So good.
No, water is
when you play sports.
No, exactly.
And you get to the break.
Dude, that is why it ruined it. It's because whenever you would run for 45 minutes straight and then finally your coach would give you a water break, you go down and you just,
oh my God,
when you took that sip of water, it literally felt like it, you could like feel it run down your body and just like cleanse you of all the suffering that you've been going through. And it's like that feeling of drinking water, you can't get when you sit down at a Mago and drink the water out of the glass. Like it doesn't feel the same. It feels like you're drinking nothing. Like at that point, that's where I'm like, okay, I can get a Coke now, or I can get like a sweet tea. Like sweet tea was a big thing in North Carolina, but as far as like water, I feel like it's a lot. I have to like force myself to drink water when I'm just regularly drinking because it doesn't taste the same as it did growing up playing sports. So,
dude, when I played football,
you played football?
Yeah, I played football from like,
what position were you?
Played running back and outside linebacker. I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty good.
Dude, I was pretty good too.
Like I was good enough to where when I decided to stop playing, it was like, how old was I? Let's see. It's probably like, I don't know, maybe it was like 7th grade to 8th grade I stopped playing. And I was good enough to where the coach for the, because I was going to move up in like an age group or whatever.
Right.
And the coach in the next, like, because I was on the Browns. There's, like, the Browns, I think, like, the little team. Then, like, the littlest team, the medium team, and then, like, the
older team?
Yeah, like, different age groups.
Okay, is this, like, Pop Warner?
For every team, huh?
Is this, like, Pop Warner? You know what Pop Warner is? Like, like just regular county.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it was like that. Fucking the coach, like the next coach up, like called my house to like try to convince me to play.
What?
Because he thought I had like a future in it. Like not like a like not like future, he was future. Like, this yeah, kid's yeah. going to be in the NFL. Just like he thought I was really good.
Yeah.
And he just wanted me to continue playing. And then he tried to convince me to play baseball.
The same coach?
He literally tried to convince me to play baseball because I had long arms. And he was like, you could be a deadly pitcher.
What? Yeah.
I'm like, I played T-ball, but I don't think I've ever, thrown a baseball, really. Yeah. But, in T-ball, sure, but baseball was never my thing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I was pretty good at football. What are we talking about?
I don't know. I asked what position you played, and then it just went downhill from there. But when you played football, were we talking about water?
Oh, yeah. Okay. The water.
Clutched.
Fucking, yeah, that break. That's how I remember it. For some reason, I guess just because I'm in a fucking helmet outside. And
yeah. Peel off the helmet and you just drink the water.
Dude, I remember because my stepdad would sit there with, the water jug. Like, all the kids' parents would, be kind of at the practice with, water jugs or something.
What?
Or I don't know. Maybe I just remember having a fucking water jug.
Okay.
But I'd run over there and just drink it. It just still has ice in it and shit.
Like a thermos, dude, yes.
And it was just so good. It's so good to where you chug it when you know you're not supposed to, because then you go out and just get a cramp.
And when you're running, you can hear it just sloshing in your stomach. Yeah, you're supposed to sip.
It's so good.
Yeah, and that's a feeling that you never get when you sit down at a TGI Fridays with a salad in front of you and you're supposed to drink the water. Just like, I don't want that. I don't want that disgusting nothingness.
I drink so much water I'm addicted to water to where I don't know how people, I remember I saw you eating the pizza earlier without a drink and it bugged me. Just because it's I can't eat anything without a drink.
Well, I can't eat pizza without drinking soda. So I knew that I would rather just not drink anything because I can't drink water after I eat pizza.
Why?
Because I've always had... Do you have certain drinks that you get at certain places?
Pizza and soda is definitely one of my things.
Exactly.
But it's not that bad of a thing to where it's I need a soda if I'm going to eat the pizza.
Yeah.
I'm just hey, if I'm going to have pizza, I don't this is bad enough.
I mean, I'd rather drink nothing than drink water with pizza.
See, I can't agree there. I'd rather have the pizza.
I mean, and there are other places where
Well, what'd you ate the turkey burger, right?
Yeah. And also
with
every
no
time
drink.
I, with no drink. No, I had a water bottle with it.
Really?
But I ate the entire turkey burger and then took 2 minutes and then drank the water. Because if I ever have a burger, it's always with a soda. It has been that way my entire life.
Yeah, but it's a turkey burger. It's not steak.
Yeah, it still tastes like I don't have a sense of smell. So it's still
guess the texture.
It all just tastes the same. But, and then it's like that. Like every time I go to Chick-fil-A, I have to get a soda. Every time I go to Panda, I have to get a soda. And so then you have to start fixing it to make it a little better. So I started going to Panda and I would get a Gatorade. And so then I got a Gatorade every single time to fix that habit. But
I mean, Gatorades aren't that much better.
I know, but
at least calorie wise, but
as far as the acidic.
Yeah. Because,
because then I would go to
Chick-fil-A. Soda has high fructose corn syrup and probably disease causing chemicals.
I mean, I would go to Chick-fil-A and then I would switch it from a soda to sweet tea, which is not that much better either. But it's still, it's less guilty, I guess. I feel less guilty drinking a sweet tea.
I see, I can't even eat anything without, my point is I can't eat without drinking something. I don't know. I can't pause, swallow.
You have to have something to wash it down.
Yeah. I don't know how people, because my, I guess, ex stepbrother used to always eat his meals without taking a drink and then drink his drink. And it would always, I'm not just like.
Just bugged you?
Because he said he enjoyed the drink that much more. I mean, when he was just thirsty as fuck at the end of his meal.
That might be the meta.
Yeah, it makes sense. I could drink water then. But it just like, it always just bugged me.
That makes sense.
Because I just like can't do it. He also ate his bologna sandwiches. He would always, or any kind of sandwich, he would just eat the outsides first, like a circle. And he would like circle around the bologna sandwich till it just got small in the middle. And then, and what's crazy is I started copying him. Because I realized that is the meta.
To eat the crust of a sandwich?
Yeah, eat the crust first. And like just circle. And then, you're just, yeah, circling.
Dude, if I saw, I would think you were weird. I'm not going to lie to you.
It is weird.
I don't really judge people, but if I saw someone circularly eating their.
Circle Sam. You don't even circle Sam.
You are king.
Circle Sam.
Your ex stepbrother is king circle Sam. Yeah. DeWitch. All right, 56 minutes.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah, we've been going. Damn. It's the coffee talking. That's what it is.
I've blacked out. I've black coffeed out.
But yeah, this podcast was originally created just because Nick has a lot of emotional tweets and people are trying to directly relate on-screen camera Nick with his emotional tweets, Nick, and very few people know the line in between. And so I feel like we were sitting in the Jeep just talking one day about like the atmosphere and the world and stuff.
Well, yeah, we always talk about how it's like our best moments
when there's a camera not on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or it's like when there's a camera not on.
Yeah, we were like, we need a vision that just visions vision.
Yeah. We need like a fly on the wall that we don't know is there. And we'll just, like, capture everything.
Yeah. And then one day, I was listening to Joe Rogan, and I was like...
Especially with some of the shit we talk about, we're just like, we need, like... We'll just talk about something so weird, we'll be like, we need a podcast.
Yeah, we do need a... Yeah, and that was why we do need a podcast, because people are like, oh, Hitch is the guy that wears weird clothes and dabs in videos. Nick is the guy that tweets about how he's going to change his life, and then he eats pizza on Sunday. But they don't get the reasoning for... Why we get motivated, why we fall off, and what we talk about to mentally wake up every day. Yeah. It's actually, I think it's pretty interesting.
Yeah, it'll probably get interesting.
I'm sure we'll talk about things throughout the, I guess, future of this podcast that is going to get, I feel like a lot of people are going to be like, what the hell are these guys talking about? Also, I feel like we should have guests on as well.
Yeah.
Every once in a while.
What's funny is Seth was like, out, or what'd I say? Seth was like, Jim? And I was like, can't, doing a podcast. He was like, let me on. I was like, no. And he was like, and he got so sad. And I was like, I'm just kidding. But actually, I don't think so. Just because I knew this was the setup. Like, we're not going to go get another mic.
Yeah.
And like randomly try figuring this stuff out. Again,
but at least not for like the first pot. I feel like there are some people that can get deep into this, or obviously I don't think we got super deep, maybe with like the law of attraction stuff, but I feel like this is pretty surface level for what we will be talking about in the future.
Oh no, it'll get weird.
Just Nick and I will sit there and talk about space and religion and different types of things, which I'm down to talk about in future episodes. And just like
get also this will be less what's the word, like a sponsor appropriate. It'll be more
of just like more raw us.
More raw.
It's not the Hitch and Maniac podcast. It's gonna be,
it's like the
Nick and Davis and Marcus, if he's sitting here, or Seth, like use each other's real names. Yeah
This would be good actually if we could. Would the guest sitting here be good?
Yeah, I think that would be kind of dope. But we would just have to move the...
Just imagine how people will look at us. We consider them guests on our podcast. And it's just me and you sitting here, like, questioning them, putting them on the spot.
Have you ever been a guest on a podcast besides the Optic podcast? Because the Optic podcast is easy.
I don't think.
Dude, I went on PKA Have you ever heard of PK? Painkiller already? It's like FPS. I think I
heard of it when you were on it or something.
It's like FPS Russia, Woody's, or FPS Kyle, Woody's Gamertag. And it's like, I honestly had never really watched it. I had only seen like different moments of it, different clips of it. Like, I know I knew Ashley had been on it a few times. And so I was like, oh, I could do PKA. It's not a big deal. Do the Optic podcast every once in a while. I used to be on the sticks. Like, I know how to talk. And then I didn't realize it was a 4-hour podcast. And they have to be on that like times 50, because those fools do not stop talking for 4 hours straight. Really? And people would be like, Hitch, you didn't really say much on that podcast. I'm like, because I can't keep up. Like, I couldn't keep up with them. They would talk about like different video games that they were playing and like different. And then they would immediately go to like different current events that were going on. And they each had like 16 different ideas and
did they have it like opinions written down?
Kind of, but we were in a Skype call as well. And so if somebody didn't really have anything to chime in, they'd be like, hey, on to the next one. And then like the guy who runs the show would be like, you guys can talk about this. And so I had nothing really to say.
I don't know if I could be a part of something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, unless maybe say this got fucking huge or something. It's like, then maybe I'll like get into, and then we start having like guests we don't really
know.
We're not like friends with or whatever.
Yeah.
Then maybe it'd be appropriate, but yeah. Like, there's a reason I don't really do interviews or
Bryson Tiller of eSports.
I'm the Bryson Tiller of eSports.
I'll do interviews.
All right. Well, are we going to make it like an hour long thing every time? I don't know.
Whatever you want to do. I don't care. Hour's fine.
It'll probably be an hour.
Yeah. I mean, hour's like I don't want to do 4 hours. It can hit that point.
Hour's like the, I guess the, I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see. But I guess that's going to do it for this one. Comments and suggestions down in the comments, please. It's going to be on my channel. Tell us what you want us to add, what you want us to talk about. Should we add? I think eventually.
Give us ideas. How long do you want the pod? Well, no, you're a fly on the wall. Ideas from you.
Who are we even talking? How long would you like
to talk? We're going to, I don't, we'll figure it out. We'll just fill it out each episode.
But that is going to do it, guys. Thank you so much for watching the humdrum.
Episode one. Thank you for watching episode one.
That's going to do it. And we'll see you next time.
Do we have outro music?